Over the years, our family's had a share of health problems.
So prescriptions are a part of our life.
Before, we went to the big box store.
We both thought it would help us save. But with the long lines and impersonal service, filling prescriptions became a chore. That's when a friend recommended D&H.
Now Tristan knows our prescriptions. Brenda always helps us find the right vitamins. And after Dad's fall, Monica's been a real expert with all our home medical needs, all without the lines.
Trust and service.
That's our D&H.
Good morning and welcome to Radio Friends. This is Wednesday, it's January the 11th, and I've got Mary Ratliff with us this morning. Mary is president of the local and state NAACP. Good to have you here, Mary.
Thank you for having me.
And you're here to talk about Martin Luther King Jr. celebration, and there is a lot going on.
There's a lot going on, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
This is Wednesday. Tomorrow there's the diversity celebration with the City of Columbia,
right,
and you will be there. But you're not here really to talk about that. You're talking about some of the other activities that are going on.
Absolutely. Yes, there will be the breakfast that starts off at St. Luke's Church on Monday.
On 16th, Martin Luther King Jr.
On
Day.
On Martin Luther King birthday. And then at 11 o'clock, the NAACP sponsorship starts at the MKT Trail on Stadium. We have annually, since that site has been there, we celebrate Martin Luther King's birthday by spending time there, rain, shine. Didn't come rain, shine, sleet, or snow.
Okay, so no matter what it's doing that
that's
day,
right.
If we have 20 feet of snow on the ground, or 20 inches of snow on the ground.
Don't hold me to that
20
one.
20 inches, you're going to be there no matter what.
If we can get there, we can get in there. If the city can get us in there, we will have the
So what goes on? What are you going to do?
At the program, we get there, we actually celebrate the fact that that Columbia has now is the fourth largest memorial.
For Martin Luther King?
For Martin Luther King in the nation.
Columbia has the fourth largest one?
Yeah, we had the third until they built the one in Washington. And so we're very proud. We're very proud of that site, and we want everybody to realize and understand that it's there and what the city has done, you know, to make sure that there's a permanent observance.
What else will be going on?
And then later that day, then we will leave there. We motorcade. We have flyers that go on the cars, and we do a motorcade from that site.
How many people will be in the motorcade?
Normally, there are anywhere the 30, 35 cars. And we are led, we have a police escort that we go down Stadium to Worley to 5th Street, and 5th Street to Broadway to Second Baptist Church. And it's very impressive.
Yeah.
And then we have, then our ceremony start there at the church. We will have greetings. We will have, we give awards to citizens who emulate Martin Luther King, those values that we think that he emulates. And so we have recipients of those awards that will be given that day at the ceremony. And then our guest speaker will be the Reverend Starsky Wilson, who was the president of the St. Louis U Youth and College Division president. Now he has gone on to have his own church. He's graduated and all that, but he is a
And all of these activities are open to everybody.
They are. They're
open to anybody that wants to participate.
Absolutely. And we're just encouraging folks. That should be a very special day for us. And so we encourage people not to just take a day off from work, but to celebrate that particular day. And after we have that service, then we will have a free luncheon in the annex of the church that everybody also...
A free luncheon?
Absolutely, okay. That everybody's also welcome to.
Now, what does Dr. Martin Luther King mean to you personally? Had you met him?
I had not met him personally, but Dr. Martin Luther King, I followed him. Everything that he did, you know. In fact, I can recall that when I lived on Bankston, we had a two-level house and our one TV, and it was on the bottom level. And I recall it being in the kitchen cooking, and I hear his voice, and everything had to stop.
Everything stopped, and you
and
went
down,
to listen to him.
Down to listen
there are
to
some
him.
People. There are some people that are have a magnetism
absolutely,
like that.
Absolutely.
A magnetism. They draw you to that persona.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
But what was the most important thing that he did that affected your life?
I think that what I'm most impressed with is the fact that he had so much to give, and so many people in his position feel like that they are giving up so much and they have so much to give up to do what he did. The fact that he gave his life, really gave his life, to try to make things better for folks. He didn't have to, because he really, you know, the truth of the matter is he was really living all right himself.
Mm-hmm.
But that he saw that there were other folks that were in so much need, that I am so appreciative of the fact that when he died, this is impressive to me, that when he died, that he was out on behalf of garbage workers. That when you just think about that, on behalf of garbage workers, people that people normally, many times, look down on, don't pay much attention to. But he was willing to do whatever he needed to do to make life better for disadvantaged individuals. He would have done that for white garbage workers. He would have done it for black garbage workers. He would have done it for Hispanics, wherever he saw that.
Well,
there was
I think
injustice.
He looked at the fact that whether you pick up trash or you're an important businessman, as long as you're doing a job,
absolutely,
your job, a person who picks up trash, that job is just as important as somebody that works in a bank.
Oh, he said that.
It's true.
He said that, you know, one of his saying, if you're going to be, what does he say, a garbage sweeper, a street sweeper, be the best street sweeper there ever was.
Yes.
If you're going to be, he said, he went through a litany of things.
Yes, because these people affect our lives.
Absolutely.
They provide a very important service to us.
Absolutely. And I think that he was able to just see that and visualize that, and he visualized people, all people, as being important individuals.
Exactly. We're just about out of time. But if he were alive today, what would he say?
He'd be up there leading that Wall Street group.
He would.
He would be there leading that Wall Street group, because I think that the injustices of the rich versus the poor in this country has gotten so out of line, so much out of line, more out of line than it was when he was here, that he would see the need to try to bring some sort of sense to this nonsense.
For more information on the activities, is there a phone number they can call?
Yes, they can call 881-0163.
Okay. Mary Ratliff, thank you so much
thank
for
you.
Coming by.
Thank
Always
you.
A pleasure having you.
Thank
having
you.
You on. Tomorrow, 4-H'ers and Art is Ageless. Our program directed by Travis McMillan of the Reynolds Journalism Institute. Audio is Pat Akers, KBIA. Our floor director is Will Claggett, and our assistant producer and guest coordinator, Uncle James Mauser. And to watch this program or to listen to it again, sign up for a free podcast or podcast, go to kbia.org. We'll see you tomorrow. Thanks for listening. Bye-bye.